Hey, in this one, I'd like to show what variable argument lists are in C. And basically, it's very similar to other more modern languages where you have a variable number of arguments in a function. So in function in Python, you have args and quarks. Like you can do def foo args quarks. Capture all extra elements. In Golang, you have the extra args, and you have that in JavaScript as well, I think. Anyway, all modern languages have it, and C has it too. Because, of course, you can guess that if you do printf of a bunch of stuff, and you can notice that the first argument of printf is always the same, but you can have any number of arguments you want at the end of it. So that's how printf does it, and now we're going to learn how you can do it as well. The use case are, well, if you don't know the number of arguments in advance, and there isn't a lot of cases for this. There is printf. One other that I've seen is exec l. The exec family of functions will just execute a command, and when there is a L, it means that it's, as you can see, the three dots, meaning it's any number of arguments. And so here you have the path to the executable, and then you have all its arguments, and it can be any number of arguments, and then you terminate it by null. So in the case of printf, it knows the number of arguments according to the format you specify, but in exec l, it would be usr bin cat, whatever. And then you would have some file second, and then you would have a null to terminate it. And then that's how we would know the number of arguments. Anyhow, I'm gonna... And yeah, okay, the last place where I saw it was in the open function, where that's the open syscall, where you have a file path, flags, and according to the flags, you have an optional argument, which is the mode. And the mode is just like the permissions of that file. And you can see that, for example, if you have I think the O create flag, it will. Try to get this mode, otherwise you don't need it, and it's an optional argument, which is somewhat neat, but yeah, that's it. Let's see how you can make use this functionality yourself. So here I've pre-built a simple example, and everything resides in the header stdarg. Yes, stdarg.h. And as you can see, it's rather simple. There is only four functions, and I've never used this one, so only three. Via start to initialize the argument list, via end to clean it, and via arg to get the next argument. And all of those are macro, and I think they are like compiler or platform specific. Never see how they are actually implemented. But let's see our simple stdarg, our simple example. So as you can see, I have a function that is called sumAll, where the first argument is a count, and count will just be the number of the next arguments. And the way I do this is I initialized my variable argument list, which is of type VA list. And AP is, I don't know, a generic name that I saw a bit everywhere. It means argument pointer. So yeah. I think, yeah, they name it like this in the documentation as well. And as you can see, you just do via start with the argument preceding the three dots. So yeah, I didn't specify, but you have to have three dots at the end of as your last argument to have this behavior. And so, for example, if I had like another argument foo here, you actually need to put foo for the variable. Actually, you have a warning if you don't. So. You can probably remember that. And at the very end, you have to free the stuff with via end, VA end. And so you can see I do just a simple for loop for each element from i0 to count. And that's where it gets interesting because then you can do via arg. You give it the argument pointer, and here you will give it the type of the argument. So, since you don't know the types at compile time, you have this where you have to actually put a type in, and it will return you a variable of that type. So let's try it out. Printf b, and then sum all of let's say three integers, which will be five. Like this, and this should be I have no clue. Let's see. Should be 18, which sounds yeah, which is correct. So yeah, that's how you do variable argument list. It's a pretty niche feature, but still useful. So yeah, that's it. See you.